evening, ladies and gentlemen. You are looking live at the Norfolk Masonic Temple here in Norfolk, Virginia. It is time for the 13th annual VCW Liberty Lottery. I'm your host, Blake Chadwick, calling the action all night long. A great card on hand, including all four championships to be decided, plus the Liberty Lottery Battle Royal. It's the late entry. The fans draw the numbers at ringside, and the winner gets a title shot at any championship of their choosing in the next calendar year. And how can you forget, also a big time special guest, Hacksaw Jim Duggan, the Hall of Famer, is in the house tonight. Luli's Lounge will be here, of course. Gino and Damian Wayne, the heavyweight title, they will be the special guest. Gino will be, of course. Will Damian Wayne interfere? You never know what could happen minutes before the VCW heavyweight title. Also tonight, the US Liberty title is on the line, last man standing. Phil Brown defends that championship against Irvin Legend. The tag titles are on the line, the Hellcats and the Golden Pinky Society in a Granby street fight. It's all going down tonight, plus the Commonwealth Heritage title is on the line. Ken Dixon gets another crack to try to regain that championship from the current champion, Colby Carino. All that plus much, much more, it's coming down right now. Let's head to the ring as our ring announcer, Brandon Matheny, kickstarts the 13th annual Liberty Lottery.
The 13th annual Liberty Lottery begins with the following contest, a last man standing match for the VCW United States Liberty Championship. In this match, there are no countouts, no disqualifications, and the match will continue until one of the competitors is unable to answer the referee's count of 10. Introducing first the challenger, currently residing in Las Vegas, Nevada. He is the best pound-for-pound athlete in VCW, weighing in at 200 pounds, Mr. Moneymaker Neckbreaker, Mayweather Promotions presents Irvin Legend.
Once again, ladies and gentlemen, to the 13th annual VCW Liberty Lottery. You are looking out a near capacity crowd inside the Norfolk Masonic Temple as Irvin Legend, wait, what the hell? Irvin Legend out here with that US Liberty Championship that he stole from Phil Brown just about 6 weeks ago. Legend, of course, knocked out Phil Brown right here in the temple with a roll of quarters. Irvin Legend, of course, was not a part of that card back in June. And now he comes out here with Phil Brown's championship. Possession appears to be 9/10 of the law as Irvin Legend trying to stake claim to that Commonwealth Heritage Championship. Or rather, the US Liberty Championship, I should say. As we've got a big-time Commonwealth Heritage title match coming up later on. Ken Dixon, Colby Carino, all four titles to be decided tonight.
Introducing his opponent, he hails from Bad News, VA, and weighing in at 265 pounds, he is the reigning and defending VCW United States Liberty Champion, the Platinum Icon, Phil.
Now, the champ is indeed here. No title around his waist, but the franchise of VCW. Ready to kickstart the Liberty Lottery, and he's walking to the ring with a purpose. You go back 3 years ago tonight, Phil Brown made his triumphant return to Vanguard Championship Wrestling, where he secured the Liberty Lottery victory, parlayed that into a Liberty Championship run. And here we go, and he goes right after Irvin Legend. Bell sounds, we are underway. Let's get ready for the 13th annual Liberty Lottery. As Irvin Legend hits the floor, as our ring announcer Brandon Matheny stated, this match is indeed last man standing. The only way to win is for your opponent to not answer the 10 count. No count outs, no disqualifications, no pinfalls or submissions in this one. As there's a very, very packed card on hand here tonight, and this is a great way to set the pace here at VCW's signature event. As Brown laid into him right on the outside, serious right hand. And remember, in this contest, all completely legal. As these two working their way around the ringside area. As Brown has Legend once again on the outside of the ring, as I stated at the top, near capacity crowd on hand. The fans are still filing in, looking at a potential sellout here tonight for the 13th annual Liberty Lottery. Looks to be nearly 500 plus in attendance. As Brown sends Legend back inside the ring. Remember, Phil Brown is the defending U.S. Liberty champion. But Irvin Legend coming out here with the championship after stealing it from Brown. Legend has been on a bit of a roll as of late. You go back a couple of months ago, he got his first win in VCW, defeating Phil Brown via countout. Oh! And again, going back to work on that left knee of Phil Brown. We know he's given that knee has given him problems in the past. We've seen the likes of Chris Silvio attack the knee, and now Irvin Legend trying to dismantle the Platinum Icon here. And look at Irvin Legend here, going for some sort of ankle lock, perhaps. Submission hold applied, but remember, this is last man standing, but a sound strategy by Irvin Legend to try to keep the champion grounded in this one, which allows the 10 count to come a little bit easier. Referee Steve Tindall counting away right now as Irvin Legend sitting back and looking as cocky and confident as ever. Mr. Moneymaker Neckbreaker looking to make a name for himself here in the biggest match of his career. And you can't take anything away from Irvin Legend, whether you like his attitude or not. Over the last year or so, not only has he transformed his physique, but it appears as if he's really stepped his in-ring game up here in VCW. And now Legend stomping away there at the knee of Phil Brown. And now he's gonna pull up towards that ring post. Brown needs to be careful here as Legend pulls him right around the ring post. And that left knee connects with that steel ring post. No padding or protection there, folks. As the Platinum Icon in a world of hurt right now. As the referee administering that count, remember, he needs to get to 10 for there to be a decision in this contest. As Legend going back to work there on that left knee. Oh, and Brown trying to retaliate with a right hand. This near capacity crowd in the Norfolk Masonic Temple telling Irvin Legend exactly how they feel about him. And Brown, he's gonna drop him rib cage first right across that steel barricade. As Legend needs to be careful, or he could be finding himself at Deep Hall just a couple of miles away. Referee once again here administering his count, but Legend back to a vertical base as Phil Brown's gonna chop him right down again. And in this instance, something like the killer, that leg lariat of Phil Brown's, or perhaps that super kick, it's only gonna soften his opponent up, not finish him off. And Phil Brown, I spoke to him before the event tonight, Irvin Legend, like that flea on a dog, just that annoying little bug that won't go away. And Phil Brown now looks right out to the crowd. And Phil Brown with that shot to Irvin Legend. I don't think he's doing it just for himself. I think he's doing it for all the fans of VCW. As Legend now finds himself on the ramp as he's trying to escape from the Platinum Icon. And Brown was on the attack, but Irvin Legend found an opening and once again is able to capitalize, taking that left leg right across the ring apron. That's largely known as the hardest part of the ring. Minimal padding or protection on that frame. And Phil Brown, that impact on that knee, very well could do some long-term damage. As this crowd telling Irvin Legend exactly how they feel about him. Never been known as a fan favorite, and that's exactly how Mr. Moneymaker Neckbreaker likes it. Hey, watch out! and Brown rears back and nails Irvin Legend with a right hand. A lot of rivalries potentially could come to a head tonight. We talked about this one for the U.S. Liberty Championship, last man standing. Phil Brown said he's essentially going to erase Irvin Legend from VCW. But what about Colby Carino and Ken Dixon? Dixon trying to get back on track and get back as the Commonwealth Heritage Champion from the man that defeated him for right back in this building back in February with a little assist from the Hall of Famer Double J, Jeff Jarrett. Of course, the Hellcats and Golden Pinky Society in that Grammy Street fight, we know about their longtime rivalry. A couple of count-out victories there for the Hellcats. Rather, for the Golden Pinky Society, as the Hellcats escape with the championship. But Irvin Legend there, modified sling blade. And Phil Brown is down, the champion is down, the challenger is down, as the referee administering that 10 count. Who's gonna be able to get back to their feet first and capitalize? As our official, nearly halfway home here, he gets to five, and Legend back on his feet as Phil Brown still struggling. Legend now, oh, learning those right hands from Mayweather Gym out in Las Vegas. And this time there's not a roll of quarters in that hand of Irvin Legend, but still packs a pretty strong punch as Legend once again picking his spots here. Maybe this is the smartest match I've ever seen Irvin Legend wrestle. As he's really picking his opportunities. As the referee once again administering his count. As Legend lying in the cut, waiting for Phil Brown to get back to his feet here. As he's about to hit seven is the official. Phil Brown back to a vertical base, but he's a little wobbly. Irvin Legend goes for the haymaker. Phil Brown takes him down with a shoulder. And that's all Phil Brown was able to do right there. That was instincts and desperation. As both of these men are down again. As the referee administering his count. As he's up to four, if he gets to 10 and both men are down. I don't know if this thing's gonna be thrown out or we're just gonna continue. But nonetheless, the Platinum Icon, he's feeding off of these fans inside the temple. Legend's back to his feet, but if he turns around, Phil Brown nails him with that discus lariat, and Irvin Legend's head nearly flies into the third row. And now the referee back to counting here as Phil Brown found himself an opening. The Platinum Icon, the U.S. Liberty Champion. The franchise of VCW looking to close the door here on Irvin Legend. As we're rapidly approaching the 10-minute mark here of this back-and-forth battle, non-stop action, bell-to-bell here. As Brown, he's going for that super kick. He wasn't able to extend that leg. Legend moves out of the way. Legend now off the ropes, and Irvin Legend with the scissor kick right to the back of the neck of Phil Brown. He caught him there right in the base of that neck. And Brown now looks to be very stunned. As Legend scratching and clawing here, trying to get to his feet. Irvin Legend now, he's on the apron. Phil Brown is down. As Brown here, again, trying to vanquish Irvin Legend from VCW, and he nails him with the super kick from the top. The impact of Irvin Legend going from the top rope all the way down to the mat, and that boot connects right underneath the chin. And Phil Brown, that might be all she wrote, but Brown's back up. And look at Irvin Legend here. Look at the fight in this young man. He's out on his feet, it appears, and Legend goes down again. Phil Brown with two super kicks. As we have eclipsed the 10-minute mark here, and Brown trying to shut the door here and reclaim the physical U.S. Liberty Championship. Irvin Legend playing possession is 9/10 of the law right there, as he thought he was champion. But Phil Brown is the rightful owner of that U.S. Liberty title, and he'd love to walk out of the temple still the champion. The referee's denying, grounds to his feet, Legend struggling, and that's gonna do it! That's gonna do it!
The winner of the match and last man standing is still the VCW United States Liberty Champion, Phil Brown!
What a valiant effort by Irvin Legend, but the veteran, the franchise, the champ is able to shut the door as a couple of super kicks is all she wrote for Irvin Legend. And Phil Brown is your last man standing and still the U.S. Liberty Champion. As Irvin Legend remains down here as the Platinum Icon, of course, a longtime mentor of Phil, of Irvin Legend is Phil Brown. Just like we saw in the past with J.J. Blake, as it seems like the students end up turning their backs on the teacher. A Legend who still appears to be down, Phil Brown, looks like he's giving him some tough love right here, a serious lesson. You have to wonder exactly what Phil Brown saying to Irvin Legend. As Phil Brown is up, he's fired up. And he will indeed walk out of the 13th annual Liberty Lottery, still the VCW United States Liberty Champion. But folks, we have just begun here inside the Norfolk Masonic Temple. Once again, I am Blake Chadwick. I'll be calling the action all night long as we still have three big championships on the docket, plus the annual Liberty Lottery over-the-top rope delayed entry battle royal, where the fans at ringside are able to choose the order of the entrance. And again, the winner gets a title shot at any championship of their choosing in the next calendar year, in any of the four championships in VCW. And I'll be very curious to see what the winner does come the end of the night. When the Platinum Icon stands tall, he is your last man standing. And Phil Brown will exit very pleased that he was able to dispatch Irvin Legend. And coming up next, folks, from what I understand, it's another installment in the long-standing rivalry between Ken Dixon and Colby Carino. The Commonwealth Heritage title is on the line, and it's coming up next.